Good morning and welcome to the E-class of St. Xavier's High School, Adipur. Today, we are going to study Science of Standard 8, Chapter Number 2, Microorganisms, Friend and Foe, Part 1. So let us talk about what are the microorganisms. Microorganisms are the organisms which we cannot see from our naked eyes. They are the living organisms and they are very small. Okay, so that we have to use any instrument for observing those organisms. Okay, without instrument we can't see these living organisms. So its definition will be living organisms around us which we normally cannot see with our naked eyes. These are called microorganisms or microbes. Now let us talk about where these microorganisms are present. Okay, they are present in water, soil and even in atmosphere. They are very tiny. Okay, they are very tiny organisms. Okay, and many organisms does not fall in the microorganism category, although they are very minute. Okay, and we cannot see them with our naked eyes. Okay, so we need some instrument. Okay, suppose a fungus. If you want to see a fungus on a bread, okay, so what will happen? We have to use a magnifying lens. Through it, the layer of the fungus will be observed nicely on the bread. Okay, in the same way, the other microbes cannot be seen by the help of the magnifying lens. In that topic or in that we have to use which instrument? Named microscope. Instrument which we have to use for the observation of a very minute organism that are microorganisms, and the instrument name is microscope. Now the microorganisms are classified into four categories. Okay, first is bacteria, fungi, protozoa and algae. These are the four groups in which these microorganisms are classified. Okay, there's one more microorganism, means not we can say microorganism, they differ from the category of microorganisms. They are viruses. Now let us see what are the viruses. Viruses are also microscopic, but they are different. Okay, how they are different? They are different in its reproduction, in its growth. Okay, uske reproduction mein and its growth, they are different in both these categories. Okay, that's why these viruses differ from that four categories of the microorganisms. Okay, these viruses live in the host cell. Okay, so wherever these viruses get into its anyone's body, okay, in that only they can reproduce. Okay, why is it so? They don't consume the nutrients from the environment. They need some host cell. Okay, whereas the microorganisms such as bacteria, fungus, okay, they doesn't need host cell to live inside it. Okay, they can grow. Okay, so they however reproduce only inside the cell of the host organisms, which may be a bacterium, plant or an animal. Yes, now let us see what are the diseases caused due to the viruses. Yes, we all know that this pandemic situation is going on. Okay, and its virus name is, that is COVID-19. Okay, this is also a type of a virus. Okay, common elements like cold, influenza and most coughs are caused by viruses. Okay, these are the common disease. Now there have been many serious diseases also caused due to viruses, such as polio, chickenpox, COVID-19, that is coronavirus. Okay, so these are the viruses which have create serious disease. Okay, disease like dysentery and malaria are caused by the protozoa. These are the microorganisms category. Okay, whereas typhoid and tuberculosis are bacterial diseases. Okay, so typhoid and tuberculosis are the bacterial diseases, not the virus diseases. And dysentery and malaria are the protozoan diseases, not the virus diseases. See, this is the image of a virus. Okay, you can see it on your screen. I have zoomed it. Okay, so this is the image of a virus. Okay, it looks like this. This is a caspid. Okay, you can see the top head is a caspid and the other one are the its leg-like structures are there. Okay, this type of structure is of virus. Okay, and the other virus structure, that is you can see, that is which is in the rounded shape. Okay, that is, see, you can see here. Okay, that are the surface protein, capsid and RNA. Okay, these are the images of the viruses. Okay, now let us see our next topic, that is where do microorganisms live? Where these microorganisms live? First of all, what kind of bacteria or these microorganisms are? These microorganisms are a single celled also. Okay, in its body only one single cell is there. Okay, another are algae, protozoa or multicellular. Okay, multicellular means an organism which is made up of many cells, more than one cell. Okay, that is more than single cell. Okay, that are known as multicellular organisms. They are algae and fungi. They live in all types of environment. Okay, if they live in very cold climate, they can live in very hot climate also. Okay, so they can adapt themselves in any kind of atmosphere or environment. Okay, they are also found inside the bodies of animals including humans. Okay, so where they live? In our small intestine. Okay, E. coli is a name of a bacteria. Okay, just for your understanding, don't worry. E. coli are present in our small intestine. Okay, in our digestion process. Okay, in our digestive system, that is alimentary canal. In that small intestine is there. At there, E. coli are present. These are the friendly microorganisms. So let us see microorganisms and us. So microorganisms play a very important and vital role in our lives. Okay, some of them are beneficial and some are harmful. Okay, we all know anything which we are having, okay, that have two points, pros and cons, positive side and its negative side. Okay, so let us see. our friendly microorganisms. Microorganisms which are used for various purposes, such as preparation of curd, bread and cake. We all know the curd, what it tastes, okay? It converts milk from the milk into the curd, okay? So how it happens? It happens with the help of the microorganism, okay? What does mama do? She takes a bowl of milk and adds a spoonful of curd, okay, and mix well, okay. So what will happen? After some time, after some hours, the whole milk will be converted into curd. Who did it? The bacteria, okay, the microorganisms which are present in that small amount of curd. What it does, it did, it converted all the milk, okay, the whole milk into the curd. Who did that? The lactobacillus, okay, the lactobacillus bacteria converted milk into curd, okay. So this was example about curd. Same way bread, cake, okay, in these also yeast is used, okay. And for cleaning our environment also, okay, that organic waste from which we can produce the manure, okay, that these waste gets converted into manure by the help of these microorganisms. So in this way they clean our environment, okay. And what does it do? It also helps for cleaning our area, okay. Yes, bacteria are also used in the preparation of the medicines. In agriculture, they are used to increase the soil fertility by fixing nitrogen, okay. What does it do? These microorganisms, they add nitrogen, okay. In the leguminous plant, in our first chapter we have studied, okay, the nitrogen is present, okay, in the leguminous plant. Who does it? Rhizobium bacteria, okay. In this way, what will happen? The fertility of the soil will increase. So now let us see making of curd and bread. We have studied that bacteria lactobacillus, okay, converts the milk into curd. How? It multiplies in milk and converts into the curd, okay. So bacteria are also involved in the formation of the cheese, pickles and many other food items, okay, such as dhokla, idli and dosa, okay. So in that, bacteria and yeast do the fermentation process, okay. So how this fermentation process is done by the yeast, let us see. What does yeast do? Yeast reproduce very fast, very rapidly. And what does it do? It, by the help of its respiration, carbon dioxide is released, okay. So what will happen? This carbon dioxide will form bubbles in the batter. Suppose we have taken a batter of idli, okay, and in that we have put the yeast for the reproduction, okay, or we have taken one batter for the bread formation and we have added yeast. So what does yeast will do? Yeast will reproduce, okay. And if so, what will happen? The number of organism will increase, okay. As the number of organism will increase, the respiration, they will do more, okay. The respiration rate will be more, so that what will happen? The carbon dioxide will release more. In that, batter. Okay, and what it will do? It will increase its volume. Suppose it is this much. Okay, and after some time, we will see that yeast has reproduced it, converted into in this much amount. Okay, so its volume will increase. Okay, this is the basis of the use of the yeast in the baking industry for making breads, pastries, and cakes. Now, let us see the commercial use of these microorganisms. Okay, microorganisms are widely used for the production of the alcohol, okay, wine, acetic acid, that is vinegar. Okay, we all know what is alcohol and wine, and vinegar is used for making the Chinese food item. Okay, in that vinegar is used. So these are used, okay, very rapidly. Okay, and who forms it? Microorganisms. Okay, many microorganisms, variety of microorganisms form these things such as alcohol, wine, and acetic acid, and it does very large scale of production. Okay, yeast is also used for the commercial production of the alcohol and wine. For this purpose, yeast is grown on natural sugars, okay, in grains like barley, wheat, rice, crushed fruit juices. Okay, so on these, yeast is allowed to produce naturally. Okay, they don't add, they do what? A natural process. Okay, so that its production will be very good and its taste will also be very nice. Okay, the smell of alcohol comes na, so what it is? Okay, and who converts it? The yeast. Okay, the smell of alcohol, why it comes? Due to the sugar has been converted into alcohol by which organism? By yeast. Okay, so the smell of alcohol comes due to the sugar which is converted into alcohol by the yeast. This process, this whole conversion process of sugar into alcohol is known as fermentation. So fermentation definition will be this. Okay, so the fermentation definition will be this three lines. So now let us see the medicinal use of microorganisms. Okay, so the medical use, okay, how the microorganisms are used for the medicine purposes. Okay, as we all know that as we go to the doctor for our any illness, okay, what does it prescribe? It prescribes us the antibiotic. Okay, so when it prescribes the antibiotic, okay, how it is produced? They are produced by the microorganisms. Okay, they, what does they do? They fight against the disease caused by the harmful microorganism such as bacteria, virus, protozoan. Okay, so what does it do? It fights against it. Now let us see its definition, that the source of the antibiotic medicine is microorganism. These medicines kill or stop the growth of the disease causing microorganism. Such medicines are called antibiotics. Okay, so nowadays these antibiotics are also produced by the help of the bacteria and fungi. Okay, let us see their names: streptomycin, tetracycline, azithromycin are the commonly named common name of the antibiotics which are made from fungi and bacteria. Now let us see that the how these antibiotics are useful and how they are manufactured. Okay, not every microorganisms are used for the manufacturing of the antibiotics, because every microorganism are not good. Okay, some are harmful, some are beneficial. Okay, so what they do for the antibiotic formation, they go very specific. Okay, and by specific microorganisms growth only this variety of disease can be cured. Okay, now antibiotics are even mixed with the feed of livestock of any poultry, okay, to check the microbial infection in animals. Okay, if any infection has been occurred in the animals or the plants, okay, what does they do? We can add antibiotic, okay, so that the disease can be stopped or the diseased microorganisms can be killed by these antibiotics. Okay, now let us see our next topic, that is vaccine. It is very important topic of this chapter. Okay, now we all know that in our childhood that you all had the vaccines by the injection form or by the drops. Okay, drops one was the polio vaccine, and by the injection form typhoid, malaria, chickenpox, smallpox, etc. These are the vaccines, okay, by the injection forms. What does they do? Let us see. When a disease carrying microbe enters our body, okay, the body produces antibodies to fight the invader. Okay, whatever the harmful microorganism enter in our body, okay, what does these vaccine do? They fight. How they fight? Let us see. When we take the vaccine, at that time we don't have any disease, okay, any kind of disease, not polio, nor smallpox, nothing. So how these vaccine are used? Let us see. Okay, the body remembers. When we take a vaccine, at that time what that happens, it adds a microbes which can be harmful. Okay, but the vaccines are not harmful. What does it do? It shows such type of structure of the microorganism which can be harmful for us. Okay, so what will happen, as the body in our body any harmful microorganisms comes, okay, so the vaccine will fight against that microorganism which are harmful. Let us see. The body also remembers how to fight the microbe if it enters again. If dead or weakened microbes are introduced in our healthy body, the body fights and kills, okay, that coming bacteria which can be very much harmful. Okay, the antibodies remain in the body. Okay, in vaccine what will happen, the antibodies which are present will be remaining in our body. Okay, and the medicines which we take, in that the antibodies doesn't remain in our body, whereas in vaccine the antibodies are present in our body. What does it do? It protects us. Okay, it protects us from those microorganisms which are harmful. Okay, this is how the vaccine works. Okay, several diseases like cholera, tuberculosis, smallpox, hepatitis can be prevented by the Vaccination. There was a worldwide campaign against smallpox so that it can be eradicated, it can be removed from the world. Okay, and finally it led to most of the parts of the world. Okay, as you all know that the polio drops are given to the up to the 5 year children. Okay, that is also a vaccine, polio vaccine drops. Okay, these days vaccines are made on a very large scale, okay, from the microorganisms to protect humans, animals from several diseases. Okay, now let us see our next topic, where these microorganisms are increasing the soil fertility. Okay, some bacteria are able to fix what? Nitrogen from the atmosphere. Which microorganism? The rhizobium microorganism. Okay, what does it do? It enrich the soil with the nitrogen and increase its fertility. Okay, these microorganisms are commonly called biological nitrogen fixers. Now let us see that how these microorganisms are helpful for cleaning the environment. As we all know that there are large amount of dead organic matter, okay, such as dead plants, dead animals on the ground. Okay, after some time what we see, they disappear. How they disappear? By the help of the microorganisms which eat them. Okay, and in this way the decomposition method is done by the help of the decomposers. Okay, and what these decomposers do? The waste material gets converted into the simple substance. Okay, in this way that our area gets clean. Okay, these are the microorganisms. Okay, these substances are again used by other plants and animals. Okay, what does they do? That these microorganisms harmful and smelly substances which are coming from that dead plants, dead animals. Okay, what does it do? It removes the smell, it removes its flesh by decomposing it. Okay, in this way they clean our environment. Let us see our home assignment. So your home assignment is define vaccine. Okay, so I hope you all understood till here. Now please write this definition in your FAIR notebook. Okay, now thank you and have a nice day.